Donald Trump is facing increasing criticism from south of the U.S. border as well, particularly from Vicente Fox, the former Mexican president. Fox wrote an editorial last week calling Trump a, quote, dictator and a false prophet, and accusing him of having, in his words, egocentric and xenophobic dreams. Fox has also used rather salty language on live TV and on Twitter to attack Trump's plans to build a border wall. And Trump is firing back. Take a listen to this.
Did you see the Mexican president, the former Mexican president? Did you see that? Vicente. So he said there is no way that we're going to pay for the... Then he used the F-bomb, right? Can you imagine if I used the F-bomb, what would have happened? Nobody even talked about it. But we've made progress because 2 years ago, he used to say, there's no way we're going to build a wall. Now he just says, there's no way we're going to pay for the wall. Trust me, they're going to pay for the wall, folks. They're going to pay for the wall.
Well, I'd like to welcome the former Mexican president to the program. Hi there, Mr. Fox. You're joining me from Mexico via Skype. Mr. Trump actually said that yesterday. He's clearly irritated with what you're saying, even if he's mispronouncing your name. You hit a nerve.
Well, first of all, hello, and thank you for this opportunity. Hello, United States. Let me tell you that I...
You're actually going to the world, Mr. Fox. This is CNN International, not CNN USA. So, you know, this is, I think you might have a lot of people outside looking into the US election race in the same way perhaps you are. But I just want your response in terms of Mr. Trump's comments. You do seem to have struck a chord with him.
It's absolutely an ignorant proposal. He doesn't understand history. He's not understanding economy. He doesn't understand how the world works. We all leaders outside of the United States feel very worried about this new voice that we are hearing of the Republican Party and of the United States. The real leader in the world is United States, and we've been working together and building a better world for all of us. So I am part of the United States. My grandfather was born in Cincinnati, Ohio. He migrated into Mexico back in 1895 without a penny in his pocket, looking for his American dream, and he found it here in Mexico.
So when we talk about the American dream, Mr. President, what happens if Mr. Trump does become the U.S. president? What will the impact be, you think, I mean, on one level, well, for Mexican-U.S. relations, but further beyond that?
First loser is the same United States, because that's not the kind of leadership that the world needs today. That's not the way to propose economic policy, to get within four walls and forget about the rest of the world. That's what President Hoover did a long time ago. He limited investment of U.S. corporations abroad on the understanding that he wanted to keep the jobs within the United States. He also imposed high taxation to imports into the United States, again, in trying to protect the jobs. And the consequence was the highest, the most profound depression that country has ever seen. That's the consequence of that kind of policies. He is claiming that he will go into a war with his Mexican trade partner. I don't know if he knows that Mexico imports from United States about $750 billion, that account for 6% of all the jobs in United States for U.S. citizens. We're talking about 10 million jobs that are generated and not produced because of Mexico's trading with the United States. He cannot just impose a taxation to cars coming from abroad, because you, the taxpayers in United States, will have to pay 40% more for each car you're buying. So it's very stupid, the economic proposals he's making.
You say stupid, you've called him ignorant, but also you have called Mr. Trump Hitler and a dictator. Strong words, even for a man who's called Mexicans rapists and criminals.
No doubt, he's arrogant, he's egocentric, and he thinks that what he proposes is to be converted into law and constitution. And that's why I call him a dictator, because we in Latin America, we suffer from that evil of the 20th century. We have enough experience on that to learn who shows on the genies, he shows on his talking, who shows on his proposals, that once he sits on the presidential chair, the chair of power, he will become a dictator, no doubt. We know about that in Latin America. We learn from Castro, that spoke very softly at the beginning. We learn from Hugo Chavez. We learn from Evo Morales. We have had so many of them that we know when a guy is not speaking the truth, is a false prophet, and he's going to take that nation to the desert.
So with that in mind, why are you sticking your neck out? Why are you engaging in a Twitter war in many ways with Mr. Trump, and you're writing these op-eds? You're being very, very vocal, one of the most vocal Mexicans in terms of reacting to Mr. Trump's views. Are you doing this out of personal outrage, or are you trying to defend the whole Mexican nation, essentially?
Yes. Why not only me, but all leaders in Latin American nations think the same? United States is very powerful. It's already very powerful and very strong. United States runs about one-third of the total world economy. And by trading and by doing business together, we benefit all nations around the world. And that's why we worry, because foreign policy in United States cannot only be addressed to its own people within the four walls that he's proposing. Foreign policy is shared by other leaders. We work together to put that policy. We work against criminality. We work against drugs. We work against terrorism. All together, we do it in Mexico. We have a very safe border in that respect. We really are very careful in issuing visas. Never a terrorist has come out of Mexico. They came through Canada or through just flying in. So I don't know why the confusion, why this guy is dedicated to destroying Mexico, to offending Mexicans. He doesn't know the enormous contribution that Mexican and all migrants do in United States. And I want to think about the Indians, the people from India, the people from Europe. If he does this to Mexico, who is going to be next? So the whole world now is united in advising, in sending the message to United States, you cannot sit in that chair, the chair that sat President Washington, President Jefferson, President Abraham Lincoln, President Kennedy, President Reagan. You cannot sit in that chair, this guy.
Thank you so much for your perspective, the global view there on Donald Trump. Vicente Fox, former president of Mexico. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much. Wake up, America.